Hey gang, in this episode, we're going to discuss who's really leading in the polls, and exactly which poll should you be paying attention to? Or should you be paying attention to a poll at all? As it's sometimes been said, the only poll that counts is the one on election day. However, there's a way to determine who's really leading. When I was conducting fraud investigations in the Secret Service, we said, follow the money, which means get the information on bank accounts, follow the amounts as it comes and goes, deposits, withdrawals, etc., etc., and find out who else is involved in the fraud scheme. With voting, individual voters, individual citizens will send financial support to their favorite candidate, to whoever it is that they're supporting. And I believe, while most political scientists say that you don't consider who's raised the most money, I believe that with respect to the individual donors, that is very telling who can be the next president. As I've said, most political scientists will go with the polls and not with the amount of money raised by a candidate. Media does the same thing. That right there is two reasons why you want to consider the financial reports. Political scientists are accustomed to using statistics. The media loves the polls because they're the ones that do them. So they'll call the people that they know that are going to give them the answer that they want, either because of that person's belief or because of how the question's worded in the first place. Then they get to control who's relevant and who's not. Another reason why most political scientists will tell you to stay with the polls and not with the money raised: Jeb Bush raised $168 million leading up to the Iowa caucus, but then at the Iowa caucus scored less than 2% of the votes. So money wasn't everything. In 2016, Hillary Clinton raised way more than Donald Trump, but lost. We're going to talk about that next. I found on opensecrets.org reports on what candidates raised in what presidential election. Back to 2016, according to Reuters, Hillary Clinton had a 90% chance of winning the presidency. That is what you call an anomaly. Something that just goes against the odds because it can. And that phenomenon is, of course, known as Donald Trump. In 2016, Hillary Clinton raised more than $563 million. Donald Trump raised $331 million. But Trump won. That began his political anomaly, which is why we're not really looking at 2020 either. Joe Biden raised a little bit less than Trump did in 2020, but still won the White House. So let's go back to 2008. In that election, again, according to opensecrets.org, in 2008, newcomer Barack Obama raised $745 million with a message of hope. Senator John McCain raised about half that at $368 million. And as we know, Obama won. In the next election, Obama again raised $738 million to Mitt Romney's $483 million. And again, was rather decisive. Obama won. So that brings us to the next question. Is 2024 back to normal? I remember my parents saying when I was a child that voting was sometimes picking the lesser of two evils. According to the Pew Research Center, America's opinions are as follows. Among Republicans, in July of 2022, 75% of Republicans found him favorable. By March of this year, that slid down to 68%, and finally 66% in July of 2023. In July of 2022, 24% of Republicans found Trump unfavorable. Up to 31% of them finding him unfavorable by March of this year, and 32% unfavorable by July of 2023. Over to the Democrat side, this, of course, is going to be another extreme. 91% of Democrats in July of 2022 found Trump unfavorable. 92% in March of 2023, and back down to 91% in July of this year. In July of 22, 8% of Democrats found Donald Trump favorable. 7% in March of this year found him favorable, and back up to 8% in July of 2023. Overall, that means that 63% of Americans currently find Donald Trump unfavorable. 35% find him favorable. And there's a 2% margin that are undecided, or actually, if you can believe this, never heard of Donald Trump. Wow. Now let's take a look at current President Joe Biden and Vice President Kamala Harris. This overlay only has the overalls, so that's what we'll take a look at and compare it to Donald Trump. Biden's overall rating among Americans, 60% of Americans rate him as unfavorable, 39% as favorable compared to Trump's 35, and only 1% is undecided or lives under a rock. For Kamala Harris, 36% of Americans find her favorable, 59% find her unfavorable, and 5% are undecided. So, with a slight edge in that poll as of this past July, President Biden leads 39% to 35%. So what do these percentages tell us? One, there remains or returns to an overall dislike for national politicians, to include our anomaly, Donald Trump. Perhaps that means we're back to pre-2016 standards and evaluations, like finding the lesser of two evils. So, with fundraising, in the second quarter of this year, President Biden raised $72 million. In the third quarter, just recently reported, another $71 million. Donald Trump, at the end of the second quarter, raised $35 million, less than half of what President Biden raised in that same quarter. In quarter three, Donald Trump raised $45 million. So a $10 million increase is very good. However, he's still $25 million behind the current president. Is that difference similar enough to the polls that we saw? Or are the polls that are being taken now showing Donald Trump in the lead the relevant ones? To conclude, I believe that the media wants to remain relevant, so they construct polls with potentially misleading results. Political scientists, for the most part, are used to stats and polls combined, but often weigh heavier on polls when talking about current events. I think the money in these cases have been blown off. because so much of those numbers are big donors. And that's true. There are a lot of statistics that say you cannot buy a president. But when you look at individual contributions, that's one, hard-earned money, and two, a form of polling during a current event. You can't deny that the individual voter is already speaking. Lastly, while Trump's fundraising seems to be picking up $35 to $45 million from one quarter to the next, he's openly using a large portion of those funds to cover legal expenses, over four indictments, 91 charges, and lawsuits now popping up over the 14th Amendment. Don't simply follow the polls or the statistics on fundraising. As I've been saying, do your homework. Don't forget that we want to thank sponsors. Right now, I've got a candle burning from Aroma by Peter. It's the leather-scented candle, makes the studio smell like a man cave. And also, Yergz.com and YergerGroup.com are done by Limit Break Digital. Go to LimitBreakDigital.com to get 10% off of your next project because you're a listener of Yergz Radio and Up the Middle. As always, show notes, scripts, social media, and links to watch and listen can be found at Yergz.com. You've been Up the Middle.
You've changed. You know that?
Yes, I suppose I have. How about this? Peace, love, dope.